Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the React masked textbox to it. Using the masked textbox component, you can mask and validate numeric values in standard input fields. You can let users enter valid data like phone numbers, date values, credit card numbers, and other standard format values. In this video, you will see how to add the masked textbox component with a few of its basic features like add a placeholder and mask configuration. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name My React App. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the masked textbox component, I type the npm install at Syncfusion / EJ2 React inputs --- save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. From 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, I import the React masked textbox component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React inputs package and add the division element with the class name as a wrapper. Inside this tag, I include the masked textbox component tag. Next, I am going to add a label to display mobile number as title, so let me add a division element with the class name as the label. Then I set the label as a mobile number. I will also define the property placeholder with the value enter a 10-digit number, which will be displayed as a hint in the masked textbox component. After that, I will define the CSS styles for the masked textbox component, so open the app.css file and import the required material themes for the styles. Here I define the text align, margin, width, and font weight styles for the wrapper and label classes. Now save the changes and run the application using the command npm start. Here, the masked textbox component renders with the short description enter a 10-digit number. To start validating user input, I may need to use the mask property. So remove the placeholder property from the masked textbox component to show you the standard mask values using the mask property. So, I add the mask property and assign a standard mask element which allows user to enter a single digit numbers ranging from 0 to 9. You can see that I can enter numbers between 0 to 9. Next, I will show you how to add value to the masked text box. For that, I add the value property and assign a 9-digit number value. Now the masked text box component displays the given 9-digit number value. Next, I will show you how to set custom mask elements. For better clarity, I remove the value property and set the custom characters property with the key fields as P and M, as I am going to display a time value. Also, I change the mask property value to the time value. To display the placeholder text first, let me remove the division element and add the placeholder property with the text value. See that I can enter the time value based on the custom mask set to it. Next, I will show you how to set a regular expression. But before I set the regular expression, let me remove the custom characters property and set the float label type property to show the label on the top while typing the value and providing a value of auto. Here, to get the 4-digit ATM PIN number, I set an appropriate expression for this mask property. Along with this, I changed the placeholder text to enter PIN code. Here, you can see the component, and I can enter the PIN code value like this. I am allowed to enter only a digit range from 0 to 9. Now, I will show you how to add the prompt characters to the mask elements. I want to add a hash character to the mask elements. So first I set the prompt character property with the value hash. Now, the prompt character hash is being shown in the mask textbox component. Finally, I will show you how to bind native events to the mask textbox. I am going to show you a simple example using the onClick event. First, I add a button and set the button content as click. And set the class name as eButtonInfo. Then I add the onClick event and assign the change event handler to it. Now, I will define the change method. Next, declare the state variable mask and its corresponding state setter function, setMask, using the useState hook. Initialize the value of the mask state variable as 9999. To access the useState hook in this application, it is necessary to import it from the React library. Inside this event handler, update the mask state by invoking the setMask function and setting its value to 2323. Then add the value property in the mask textbox component tag and set its value using the mask state variable. After that, I will define the CSS styles for the button, so open the app CSS file and import the required material theme for the styles. And define the margin left and margin top styles for the eButton class. Now, when I click the button, the mask textbox value changes to the new static value passed inside the callback method. In this video, I have shown you how to add the mask textbox component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like mask configuration and supported native events. If you would like to see the working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.